Welcome back to Let's Play Popful Mail, the only place on the internet you can watch some guy ramble while he plays Popful Mail. Let's see if this guy has anything else to say before we go up. No. This next part is a bitch. These wizards, or witches, are way tougher than the ones we encountered earlier. If you don't take this extremely carefully, then you're almost guaranteed to die. As a matter of fact, let me save real quick. And they don't give you any gold either, which is a total ripoff. You can't let them gang up on you like this. But you can. Oh, I hate these witches. Okay, looks like I got them both in a pattern, so that's good. Is that it? Oh, I remember that being much harder. Hey, got the prison key. It won't budge. Damn it. Maybe the person in the cell will tell us how to budge the lever. There we go. Oh yeah, we have to go in. Alright, cutscene coming up.
Whoa, how in the world did you get past the wizards?
Doesn't matter. You're free, so fork over the 500 gold.
Geez, no time for pleasantries, huh? Follow me to the village and I'll pay you there.
I thought you had the cash on you. This better not be a trick.
No tricks. I just don't carry 400 gold on me.
Oh, no you don't. We agreed on 600.
600 gold? Are you insane? I know it was 500.
Okay, sissy boy. 500. Hand it over.
Like I said, at the village.
We'll never see that guy again. Oh, look who's Mr. Muscles. I could have flipped it if I tried hard enough.
I don't know how to thank you properly, Mail, but I'm sure this will help. Say, I heard that the Gingerbread Grifter Gang and Muttonhead are working together. Don't know if it's true, but it makes sense. That's the second time I've heard that. I'll stay here to defend my village. Hopefully you'll find Muttonhead and put a stop to his crazy shenanigans. The ladder to the right will lead you out of here. Good luck, Mail!
Crazy shenanigans. I can't believe he actually gave us the money. Oh, stop, you're killing me. Yeah, wouldn't that be great? So let's see. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I want to stop by the village before I continue to Golem Tower. Golem Tower.
My precious tower.
Who are you?
I just can't believe it! My wedding ring was stolen by the Badger Gang!
Badger Gang?
Yes, they're ruthless criminals with a hideout near here. Oh, I just don't know how I'm going to break this news to my husband! Oh.
Maybe you won't have to.
Yeah, I don't know where that is. So, maybe I'll look it up or something. What do you have to sell? Amulet, orange, cherry. Well, heal me first of all. Well, I'm 500 gold richer. I forgot about that. This isn't a very long game. I have about, 7 hours of total play time in the game that I beat. But that's not counting the numerous times I had to die and restart and do parts over and all that. I'd say it took me at least a solid 10 hours or so. Oh yeah, the mine. We'll get there eventually. Well, I'll go ahead and take that shield off of you. How much is that dagger? 300? Sounds pretty good. Give me a little something. As you can see, there's a blue meter down there next to arms now. And we can throw daggers until it runs out. We can also use the dagger to stab, but why would you do that rather than switching to the sword? Actually, the dagger's pretty good. I think I'll stick with it. Oops. And I... Damn it, I already equipped the I'm me good talker. Yeah, 7 hours and 15 minutes, and that's my backup save for that game, so... It's a pretty respectable length, especially for 1994, when our standards were much lower. I mean, geez, just look at any of the Sonic games. I can blow through those in 45 minutes at the most. Oh, I hate these things. Those logs that they spit don't hurt you, unless you're near them when they're exploding. Otherwise, you can run into them and walk on them, whatever else you want. Actually, I think I will use my sword here. It's a little easier to use it against these wood things. This is when the enemies start getting a little tougher. As you can see, these things take a pretty good amount of hits before they die. The dagger and the sword both do the same amount of damage, by the way. It's just the dagger is a long-range weapon, and the sword is short-range. Don't stick your tongue out of me. That is so rude. It's log, it's big, it's heavy, it's wood. Man, I'm broke now. I spent all my money on daggers and swords. Just the bare necessities, you understand. To the left. To the left. To the right. To the right. Whoa! Okay, this bee is bad news. If you try to fight him, it's just gonna end in tears. So wait until he attacks and then blow past him. That's a bad news bee. I don't know, is there such thing as a good news bee? I mean, let's be honest. I don't know, I guess honeybees are good news. Everybody likes honey. Except for babies who choke on it. Because they just don't know. The parents just don't know. Don't feed your babies honey. If there are any parents listening, and I really hope not, because most of my audience is like 14 to 16 years old. But if by chance you have a baby under the age of something. Oh, God. Oh, a fruit fly just flew up my nose. Oh, that is disgusting. Why is there a fruit fly in here? Oh. I'm not joking. It flew directly up my nose. Oh. Whoa. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Don't feed baby spinach. Because they're just going to hate it for the rest of their lives if you force it on them. Same with broccoli. Feed them to it later. You know, don't force them to eat it. Give it to them. Give it to them a little bit at a time. And just let them get used to it. I mean, I had broccoli ruined for me and spinach. Because all I had was the freaking canned spinach. And nobody likes that. At least, whoa! Oh, God. I better stop it here. Okay, tune in next time for Let's Play Popful Mail, where I will attack whatever this thing is. And talk some more about food. I'm Duke of the Bomb. Good night and good luck.